Well, hello. We're going to start in a few minutes. Well, 1 minute, about 1 minute. I'll wait for a few minutes to a few people to come on. Welcome to my first live, actually. I just thought I'll admit it there because I haven't done this before, probably. And I'm looking forward to joining me and doing this workshop today. So thank you for coming on board with me. I'm going to have a bit of fun. I'm going to share a bit of my journey, some of the things that have really helped me over this time. You know, we're all come through quite a big few years, couple of years. So creativity has been really important to me. So I'm going to start pretty much right now. Welcome. It's so good to have you all here. And this will actually be pre-recorded. So you'll be able to watch this later. And yet those of you that are watching this later, welcome as well. So good to have you here. So today you will have seen some of the promotion probably that I did. I was holding up this little picture here. So we're not actually going to be doing all of this over the next 3 days. It's three 45-minute sessions, one today, one tomorrow, and then one on Monday in Australia. But we're going to be learning to do, on the last day, we're going to be learning to do one of those little water drops there. I don't know which one yet. We'll make a decision as to which one. So that's going to be fun. And what you can do is get ready. You know, you might have oil paints, you might have just pencil, you might have acrylic, watercolor, whatever, because I know at the moment not all of you may have oils at home. So we're going to do that on the last day. And tomorrow we're going to be looking at interviewing some students. That's going to be fun too. But first of all, hi, I'm Heather Bradbury, and I live in Melbourne, Victoria, live in the beautiful Dandenong Ranges. We've had an interesting year. We had storms and we've had trees fall over and all sorts of crazy things amidst lockdowns, many lockdowns. Apparently Melbourne's been the most lockdown in the world, I hear, I think. It was a few weeks ago. So that's been a bit of fun, sort of, yeah. So, but for me, I have, over the last few years, started a gallery and teaching students, and that all came not very quickly or not straight away. It all began a number of years ago when I actually burnt out. I'm a mum of four beautiful boys, men now, all grown up, left home, and stunning creatives. But I burnt out. I took on too much, way too much, and I decided that I needed to stop. I was doing graphic design, all-nighters, working for an international organization and traveling around the world and leaving kids with friends and, way too much. So, I just thought, well, look, I need to stop. And when I stopped, I started to use my hands again. So I actually thought, well, I'm going to start to draw something. And I've actually got a picture here of it. Here we go. Let's see if I can get this without a glare. There we go. There's a picture of it there. And what I thought might be fun, look, if I go like this, you can see the mountains in the background. Look at that. Hey, that's where I live. Yeah. But yeah, so that's what I first drew when I'd burnt out. And it was actually called Blessings because at the time I thought, I don't know what a blessing is in my life. I was really sick. I wasn't feeling well. And I didn't know what the future was. And it felt really, ugh. So I did that, and I felt like those water drops were about life. You know, water is life-giving. If we don't have it, we're going to die, basically. So I think that gave me a little bit of hope. And from there, I went on and did other paintings, no intention of anyone seeing what I was doing. And, friends just said, why don't you put it in an exhibition? And I'm like, oh, yeah, sure, but I don't really want to. And I did, and it got recognized, and then sold them for a decent amount of money. I'm like, whoa, this is amazing. And then I just started to have this passion of wanting to teach others as well. I'm excited to be able to share some of those stories tomorrow with you of people that have traveled that journey. So this painting behind me, this was done a couple of years ago. Which way am I going to go here? this was painted just before my dad actually died, which is a really sad time for me. Love my dad so much, miss him. But it was called Eternity, and a lot of my paintings now are, all of them, I should say, are about following that journey, following using my art and using my painting to be my visual journal. So that one was called Eternity, because I felt like when I was holding his hand in those last few minutes, that I was sort of there with him as he went, where his spirit went somewhere. It was an incredibly beautiful moment. So, yeah, my painting is very deep and to my soul, and I love teaching people to actually paint like that as well. So I'm going to be sharing with you, you know, on Monday, some of the courses and things that I'm doing in the future. And that's one of the reasons I love offering these workshops, is because I can then also tell you some of the other things that you can get involved in the future. So there's some wonderful things that have come. Oh, I was just about to say wonderful things that have come out of COVID. Okay. But I think you know what I mean. A lot of you will have known that we've had to slow down a lot, and, you know, I've had time to do some creative stuff. We also know that it's been a very, very challenging time, incredibly challenging time for many of us and the world. But I think for me, as I just came and stayed home and I just went, okay, I think I need to do something with online, because I had to stop all my classes, my in-face classes and my gallery and everything just stopped. And like many, many millions of people around the world, our businesses had to stop. So I went online and I started developing some courses. So where have we got here? So these are some of the little, what I ended up doing was a small version of my bigger paintings. So aren't they cute little things? So it's a shiny, there we go. Here's a few of them. There it is, aren't they? So this one, the real life one, is like massively bigger than that one. This one here, this is one of the first paintings I ever did. I don't even know which way it goes at the moment, that way. Whoop, whoop, there it is. Yep. Oh, this one's cute. Little froggy. Anyway, there's a whole heap of other ones of those. So, yeah, that was quite a lovely journey to be able to offer that and put that on the line. But I'll talk about that in a couple of days' time. So, yeah, that's a little bit about me. I love creating. And my sort of catchphrase now is helping people discover their creative voice. But also it's about giving people that opportunity. I think everyone deserves an opportunity to discover their creative voice. So we're going to have some fun over these 3 days. The last day, like I said, on Monday, or wherever you are, it might be Sunday afternoon, we're going to be learning how to do a water drop. And that's a very important thing for me, because, like I said, it was the first painting that I did, you know, this one here of the blessing. So it's really based on that, that whole thing. So, yeah, so that's a bit of fun. So I thought today that it'd be really great to look at some of the things that I found really helpful, especially over the COVID-19 time, creative-wise, to actually help us move through. You know, that sort of, what is it, that COVID-19 just feeling of, I don't know what words we could use. There's all sorts of words that's happened or that we feel at this time. Fatigue is one of them. And right now we've actually just come out of quite a lot of many lockdowns, and we've just sort of been in Melbourne, and we've just been trying to adjust to being around people again, and it's quite exhausting. So, you know, I think for me, going back to creating is a really important thing. In fact, I'll probably, I'll probably show you in a moment a painting that I did only a few weeks ago, just before we opened up. Because I was quite nervous about opening up and all the things that we had to do to comply with all the regulations and stuff like that. I think I really want to share with you tomorrow also how my journey has actually helped my students now, and like the story that I've had, and being sort of authentic about how I've used my creativity and my painting especially to help my journey. And now, you know, seeing so many students, you know, exploring and finding just incredible healing, and it's helped them in their whole journey. And I'll tell you some more stories tomorrow, just some amazing stuff. So I just feel so privileged to be in this place, so to be able to do this stuff. All right, I'm going to show you now. First time I've sort of used all this program here. I've used Zoom a lot, but this is a new thing online. So I'm just going to share a photo of the painting that I did just a few days ago. Okay, and That'd be right. It's not showing. Hold on a minute. I love it, love it, love it. Escape that. Great. Okay, now we'll get it. Okay, so share. So this is a picture of, it's actually a picture of an eagle, as you can see. So this was, you know, a lot of my paintings have been about water and reflections. And as I'm sort of exploring now, it seems to be that I'm just basically attracted to an image and going for it and loving that part of exploring my creativity. This I did over 3 days, and I was so busy at the time trying to open the business up, and wasn't an easy time, but I just went, blow it, I'm going to stop and I'm going to create and I'm going to paint this painting. So it's a beautiful picture of a eagle by a friend of mine, and it sort of cut off here, and that was the way the painting, the photo was that she had, but I actually love it because it's quite mysterious, and for me it felt like, oh, you're being carried, it's good, okay, we're going to get through this big time of coming back after being so locked down for so long and now being amongst a lot of people and managing a whole heap of things. So yeah, so that was quite a journey, but it was a really important journey for me to stop, and that's what I like to important journey for me to do, and that's what I really encourage my students to do, is embrace creativity even when life's really busy. Well, even more so when life is really busy and stressful, because you know, creating, and it doesn't have to just be painting. We know that is such a healing thing and such a helpful thing. And during COVID, oh my goodness, it's been incredibly helpful. So I thought we might share, I've got this sort of document that is floating around all my material and online and stuff called 6 Creative Things that will help you have your best creative year. 6 things that can help you have your best creative year yet. So I thought we'd start with that. Now I'll just find the little document here. It's a bit of fun. So it's really just things that has actually really helped me definitely on this journey. I'm just going to get my picture in here so you can see me too. So the first one is eliminate stress in your life. Now, how do we eliminate stress in our life? And I think I was reading a book, and I actually don't remember what the book is now. Maybe in the notes that I did up here. No, probably not. But it says, yeah, write down 10 of the most outrageous things you could do now to eliminate stress in your life. I've got ballet classes. I don't know if that's outrageous. I mean, if you don't like doing ballet, I suppose that's outrageous. But walking 4 hours a day instead of just half an hour or not. Hide your phone for a day. My beautiful flatmate is often does that, and I love it. Just like, yep, I haven't even turned it on today. I'm like, wow, that's awesome. Go you. So I just thought it'd be fun if you could type in the chat and say something outrageous you would like to do. That, because I think we don't allow ourselves to actually do outrageous things sometimes. I don't know if any of you know The Artist Way, Julia Cameron. I run the course. We've done it online a few times in the last couple of years. But yeah, she's always about the artist date. Go and do something on your own that's you love doing. I mean, that's not necessarily outrageous, but you know, it gives you that idea. We need that. That's what brings us life. So I'm just trying to think what would be something outrageous for me right now. Probably because it's not quite warm enough at the moment. Going and swimming in my pool would be really, really outrageous because you come out blue, basically. Now, again, my lovely flatmate will do that, but I'm not going to do that quite yet. I'm going to wait for the warm weather to come. So write down. I don't see any posts yet. Come on, guys. What's something that you could do that could eliminate stress in your life? You know, like it might be social media. Let's just turn off. You know, no, don't turn it off here now. I don't want you to go right now. But, you know, it might be, I don't know, make a banquet meal and invite people over. I don't know, something that you just outrageously sort of want to do. And, you know, doing those things that you really love and that feel a little bit out there, sort of just something in your mind just relaxes and it's a beautiful thing. So I really want you to think about that. I will put a link to this document. We'll probably link this into the next email that we send out with the replay so that you can have a look through it and print it out and even do it yourself. So that'll be a bit of fun. So have a think about that. Outrageous stuff, okay? I don't think I've been outrageous enough with the things that I've suggested here. Let me think of something else that's outrageous. Climb a tree? I don't know. Might be. I've got a few trees out there. That's why I thought of that. But I haven't done that for a few years. So thinking of doing things that are outrageous. Okay, this is great. You, now I don't know how to say your name, Anaruda, it's a beautiful name, like wants to do ballet classes. I reckon, you know, I haven't done ballet since I used to be a ballet dancer. I reckon it'd be 30 years. Okay, I'm not that old. 30 years, and I'm actually going to take up ballet classes in a couple of weeks again. Actually, yeah, so it's gonna be fun. So thank you. Yes, ballet classes, fantastic. So that's the first thing. So think about that and keep writing those out, guys. Doesn't have to be, you know, you can be doing that while we're talking about the next thing. And then I've sort of got, you know, write down the steps you can take to do this today. So you could get on the internet, find a local ballet school and actually make that phone call. Yeah. That's awesome. Or you might want to do, I'd love to do Latin dancing. You know, it's a little bit, you know, like close with other people and people you don't know probably, but I think it'd be really cool to learn that. Actually, that would feel outrageous for me. The next one is find a good book. Find a good book. You know, I've never been a really good reader, but when I do find a good book, I love it. So I've actually been listening to Brené Brown a lot. I don't know if you know Brené, but she's, she does a podcast and she almost always interviewing someone who has written an amazing book. So I might actually get my friend here to go and get the book, that book about reading. No, the one with all the big book with all of the pictures of the house, decor and stuff. Yeah. So I was like listening to one of her podcasts and I'm like, oh, this is really cool book. And it wasn't just like, you know, a book that you would just read just with words in it. This book is, oh my goodness, it's so stunning. I will show you. She's about to bring it in here. Oh, we're this way. I was looking the wrong way. But this is Jungalo, Decorate Wild, you know, and I love decor and stuff. So, you know, all her stuff is just stunning. Just look at those colors, you know, just spending time looking through this book has been just so fun and quite a little bit indulgent, but I've actually really, really loved it. So find a good book. If you like a book that, you know, gives you a story or a novel or whatever, you know, everyone's different, but I like books with color and stories about, you know, her as well and what she loves, or the writer as well. So that's a bit of fun. So find a good book. I've got here, or maybe you want to write your own book. Maybe you want to do some writing. Write your story out. That would be really cool. So start writing and, you know, sometimes that can really be a beautiful healing time to be able to write your own story and think about the things in your life that you'd love to share with others. Have a bit of fun doing that. Number three, find a mentor. Find someone who believes in you. We need people who believe in us. And if you tell them your dream, they're not going to laugh at you, you know. So I've got here, write down how many? Well, I've got four spaces, four people that you could contact. And I bet I've write down what you would share with your mentor and ways that you can be accountable as well. So I think it's really important to do that and to find people that you really trust, because they can actually reflect back to you and go, well, you know, yep, I wonder whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, and to be able to share that and really get that confidence and be able to find someone you really, really trust. So, so that's that one. Find a mentor. All right, what have we got next? Walk and document. Walking, oh my goodness, I don't know about you, but when we've been in lockdown, you know, it's lockdown. It's like we haven't been able to go more than 5Ks traveling and only to the supermarket and blah, blah, blah. So The only other thing that we could do, pretty much, apart from going to buy food, was walking or driving 5Ks. But that wasn't very exciting and didn't last long. So, you know, walking has been a huge, huge, huge part of my journey in this last little while, and actually not just during COVID at all. I'm going to find a photo here, so I'm looking somewhere else, but of where I walk. So, yeah, it's a stunning place right here where I'm living. Share screen. It is just this. I'll show you here. Look at this gorgeous, gorgeous picture here. So this is, a walk that I've been on, I don't know, days and days and days and days and days over the last few years in the Dandenong Range. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. And, you know, for me, walking is a time to, you know, I've got no social media. I've got no, like, my phone on silent. I use it. I take it with me because I want to take photos for reference and also just to remember things. So that's been amazing. And I think walking in the bush helps slow me down so much. And I actually love going. This is actually probably very close to the spot that I love walking. It's about a 40-minute walk. It's about an hour's walk there and back to where I go. And I love stopping and just listening to the birds, listening to the sounds. And I keep, this is my outrageous thing, although it's not very outrageous, but I want to lie on the ground. But there's leeches up here. Okay, I don't know if you know, I don't like leeches at all. I don't know about you, but there's these little things that suck your blood. So I don't want to go there, but I'm going to take with me like a towel or a tarp or something. I've got to try and remember to put in my backpack and just lie on the ground and just breathe in, you know, what's going on. It just takes your mind to a completely different space to what you're in when you're back. You know, for me, I do a lot of work online. And it's so refreshing, so refreshing. And for me, I love to do that gratefulness stuff and just be thinking about, you know, for me, it's, there's a creator somewhere doing something. How did that tree, you know, just thinking about the beauty around me, which is just it's so wonderful. And then I've got walk and document. So, you know, what I've done in the past way back is I photograph a lot of stuff, and I also like to print those photos out and then write about them. It's a whole heap of things, different things I do. I have an online journal as well. There's heaps of resource out there. Mine's called, it's called Journal, basically. If you look up an app store and you look up Journal, you know, I put up a photo and then I just write a bit about that and I document, and it's really great. And it's been wonderful over this last couple of years to be able to document moments. We've had such diverse things happen over the last few years. I'm living in the mountains, like I say, and we've actually had really bad storms, like a cyclone-y type thing come through, and just to see some of the things that's happened and what we've done over that time supporting the community has been just huge. So to be able to document that as well, and I think when it comes to creativity, documenting and having photos and writing, sometimes you can look back. Like this photo actually behind me here, sorry, photo, this is my painting. This painting behind me was a photo that I'd taken, a year before. And so looking back through my photos and looking back through my journals and listening to myself talking about, you know, that time when I took this photo was really important for my creative journey. So I encourage you to do that as well. So on the document, let me pull that one up again so you can see it. We've also got, let's find it for you. So there's little spots here. We can tick a little box. We like ticking box. I like ticking boxes. Lists, we like ticking things off. So write down a list of beautiful walks, beaches, parks, forests, things that you like to do, be adventurous, even somewhere very unusual. So when I was writing this, I think I might have even been in lockdown, so it was challenging. I'm like, yeah, I'd love to go for a big long walk, blah, 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 somewhere else where I could drive. So hopefully most of you are not necessarily in major lockdown. But if you are, dream ahead to a time that, you know, in somewhere, even if you want to go to another country eventually, where would you like to walk and document? I know a lot of people love to travel overseas to different places and have these dreams. Dream. I want to encourage you to dream. Yeah, it's good, good. So that's number four. Number five, journal is journal. journal is a huge, huge thing for me. Again, the artist's way, Julia Cameron. Oh my goodness, her material is amazing. And you know, she encourages us to write every day, and 3 pages of writing a day. Now, I don't necessarily do that all the time now. I do when I'm running the courses, but I do it probably 3 times a week. And I just love it. It's just a brain dump. It gets everything out. And it's amazing what happens, because you retain so much in your mind, and you're going over things so much, and especially when things are really challenging and stressful. So to be able to get it on paper is actually like a release. I know a lot of people, you know, have said, oh, I'm not much of a writer and blah, blah, blah. Well, either am I. I almost failed English at school. Seriously, I did. And still have trouble with spelling. You'll probably see that in some of my emails. But, you know, I love writing now. I love writing out what's going on in here. And Julia Cameron encourages us to the stream of consciousness, which is, okay, I don't want to write. I hate writing. My writing is terrible and I'm a terrible speller. And then you just keep writing, right? Okay. Oh, look at the bird out the window. And I'm really worried about this. And you know, you eventually, that's why it's 3 pages. Eventually you start to go, oh gosh, I'm feeling like this and I'm feeling stressed. But then towards the end of your time of writing, it's like, oh, it's not that bad. It's going to be okay. I got through this before. And look, I need to do that. You know, I really do. As a business owner, an artist, as a teacher, a mentor, I need to get out what's in my head, because I don't want to take it and dump it on other people. I just don't. I want to be able to be clear-minded and be able to work through my stuff. And yes, I've got mentors as well that can work through, you know, other things and particular things. But some things are just what I need to get on the paper and can stay there. Our brains go all sorts of places. So this is one of the journals that I did a while ago. I haven't quite got back to it, but what I would do is, for each painting, I would take a photo of, well, I put a photo of the actual painting. So this picture here is actually of the same, actually, no, it's not. It's a different spot. This is in Tasmania, actually. So that's the photo, but then of course I went on and did a painting, but I will write a lot about, you know, the actual name. So that was called Restoration, and I would look up things like in even the dictionary, what does restoration mean? And then, you know, I had a blackboard at the time, and I took photos of what I was drawing on the blackboard and just kept writing. You know, I love just putting things, you know, just continuing to put photos of the finished picture as well, and just having a bit of fun with that. And when I've been doing courses, some of the courses that I'll talk about, or one particular one, as we move through this workshop, it's been a really important time. We actually encourage people to take a journey and a journal and a journey, and document some of the things that they're doing. And some of the women that have been doing it have been taking photos of their art, taking photos of their, you know, their images that they've been painting, but also writing about COVID-19, because they've wanted their grandchildren to actually read this document later. It's sort of like a document, a history document, you know. So incredible. Some of the ideas that people have come up with has been fantastic. So journaling, it's just been a lifesaver for me. I discovered also over the last, you know, couple of years, it's amazing. I've just ordered it for Christmas presents. Hopefully no one here who's going to get it will know that I've actually got that. But anyway, hopefully it'll be a surprise. But it's the 5-minute journal. You know, okay, we talk about this three-page thing, but if you're not much of a writer, I thought, okay, let's have a look at this 5-minute journal. And Ramdas is how you say, and Alex, okay, created by these guys. And they looked into behavioral science, and it's helped hundreds of people find meaning in their lives by working with them one-on-one. But this is what they do each day. They write every day, I am grateful for, what would make today great, and then a daily affirmation, 3 amazing things that happened today, and how could I have made today better? And he's got this lovely layout and these great books. So I'm really excited about getting them in the mail and having one for myself and a gift for other people for Christmas, which will be really cool. Just journaling. I really, really encourage you to do that, especially, look, when I say especially, I think all of us have things that we go over and over in our mind. It might not be that you're majorly stressed, but to be able to get that out is super, super helpful. I can't stress that enough. Hey, hey, hey. All right. The last thing, which we're actually going to do a little physical activity with this before we finish today, is play. We don't allow ourselves to play much and take a little bit of risk. So, you know, doing something, you know, I have so many students go, I can't draw. I don't want to pick up a pencil. I can't even draw. Look, pick up a pencil and just scribble. You don't have to, you know, no one else is going to see it. Just create something, play. So, you know, again, I'd love to ask you to write down, you know, what's some of the ways that we could play? Play creatively. You know, you might have a musical instrument in your house that you have no idea how to play. It might be a guitar. You don't have to play the guitar. You just drum on it, or you could just use your elbow on the strings to make a sound, you know. Think of doing things a little bit fun and funky and different, because we often will have that expectation that we have to play the piano or play the guitar perfectly, like a classical piece. But allowing yourself to play is so, so important, and it's freeing. It's so, so freeing. When I've done the Artist Way course, in fact, we just finished up a 12-week course 2 nights ago. We had a bit of fun just shutting our eyes, which we're actually going to do this activity in a moment. I'm going to put on a fantastic piece of music, which you will love. And I'm going to encourage you right now to find a piece of paper. Even if you've only got your computer or your phone, I don't know, there might be a drawing program on there, but I think a bit of paper would be better. If you grab some paper, you could grab a pencil or a texter, or what have I got else here? I've even got some charcoal. You might be super organized. You might be saying, no, not that that's necessarily organized, but you might have paints right near you. I don't care what you use, but you can actually, we're going to put some music on and we're going to have some fun drawing. Okay. And I want you to shut your eyes and just let your hand just go wherever it goes. How's that sound? So hopefully you've got some paper near you. I'm going to give you a minute or so to do that while I find some music for you. But I'm just going to say hello to those who are here. Lorraine from Morpeth in New South Wales, welcome here. And Anne, lovely to see you, Anne. Great. Yes, Anne is doing one of my courses and doing a super, super great job. Anne has never done oil painting before, and I'm just loving what's happening for you, Anne. It's fantastic. Anna Runda, I hope I'm saying that right. It's lovely to have you here as well. And all of you that are watching on and watching the replay, it's great to have you here. So I'm going to put some music on, and I would like you to get your paper and pencil out right now. No, don't wait. Don't just go, I'm just going to stop this video right now and go and get a cup of tea. Go and get it now, because we want to play. We want to release that creativity that's there. And remember that creativity is not necessarily producing something that someone else is going to see. It is not about that. It is about you just letting something happen that's coming from inside. And if someone else sees it, great, but it's about your journey. It's about what you you need to express yourself. And that's why I've done these paintings, you know. And seriously, when I first started, I didn't care that no one would see anything. It was more about, it was about the journey. It was about me healing from burnout, finding a way to move forward, finding my voice again, because basically when I burned out, a whole heap of other things were happening around me. That's family stuff to do with, you know, mental health, which was really, really challenging. And, you know, I thought my life was almost over, and I was probably only in my 30s, you know. So, you know, it's just so important to be able to use those things and that creativity. All right, I'm going to put some music on. Hopefully you can hear this okay. Don't worry, be happy. I think we need that. Yeah. All right, come on, guys. It's not going to be just me doing this. Go and get your paper and pencil. All right, and I'm going to do it too. And I'm going to shut my eyes and I'm going to draw. And just let the music, yeah, just flow over you and help you have a really good day. It's going to go for 5 minutes. Stick with me and keep doing it.
I want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy. In every life we have some trouble. When you worry, you make it double. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Be happy.
Keep your eyes closed.
Don't worry. Be happy.
You can sing too.
Got a place to lay your head. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry. Be happy. The landlord say your rent is late. He may have to litigate. Don't worry. Be happy. Look at me, I'm happy.
Did I wish you could actually show me all your pictures. It'd be really cool, but I hope you enjoyed having a bit of a go at that. You know, it takes you into a different mindset, especially when you're not thinking that you have to draw something. I have to draw a house, or I have to draw a specific thing, and just letting go. You know, I love doing that activity actually with ink and a really big piece of paper and brushes, and just letting people just fully, you know, enjoy that flow. So Yeah, I'd love to hear any questions or any comments that you have about this session today. You know, even if this is after time, there'll be a spot to, after the live, a spot to write comments, what you found helpful, because this is the first time I'm doing this workshop. And I think for me, I want to know, you know, what is going to be most helpful for you. This is why I'm here. I'm here to help you discover your own creative voice. And, you know, like I say, everyone deserves an opportunity. So I want to be able to find ways to give you an opportunity to do that. So I hope you've really enjoyed having a bit of fun with that today. And I'm super excited about the next few days. I'm going to get some people on to do some interviews and talk about, you know, how creativity has been really helpful for them, especially painting. And most of you will know, because you've seen, you know, the promotion, you've seen this, that obviously I'm a bit of a painter and I love painting photorealistic painting. And I think for me, I didn't really mention much before, but for me, that process of actually taking time to slow down and just meditate almost, well, it is. It's like a meditation as I'm copying the image onto here. You know, some people say, well, not many people, but there is the thought that, like, why are you painting something that's so photorealistic when you could paint, when you could just print the photo out? I'm like losing my words. But for me, it's not about, you know, oh, I just want to see that picture on the wall. It's not about that. It's the process that's the most important. So, you know, this actual image I painted because of the trees that were falling, that the big challenges that we had in the hills. A lot of people lost their homes. You know, our landscape looks very different now. And I wanted to remember the beauty of the trees. You know, so it wasn't a picture that I was going to go about necessarily and sell. And, you know, I wasn't thinking about that as I was first doing that. It was about the journey and the process is the most important as you take this journey. So, like I said, I'm really looking forward to sharing with you some of the resources and things that I have to offer you. We'll be sharing a bit more of that over the next few days. But yeah, if you have any questions, if you really love me to share something over these next couple of days, please message in the comments, let me know, and I'd love to accommodate that. I hope you've enjoyed this time, whether you're watching it live or whether you're watching it later. I hope you've really enjoyed, just taking this journey on reviving your creative soul, especially during this COVID-19 time. So I'm going to finish up now and hope to see you all again tomorrow, 9 a.m. AED time, daylight saving time in Melbourne and Australia, and I look forward to sharing with you more some stories tomorrow, which will be really cool. So come back again. It's lovely to have you here, and thank you for joining me. We'll see you next time.